Up, y'all. This is the One Nation Podcast, A64. You ain't here with your boy Rook tonight, man. I'm going to let my boy Jay-Z play for a minute. Forever young. But that's what we want to be, right? Forever young. You know what I mean? Y'all know I like to rock out. Living life like a video. Forever young, man. Hey, yo, what's going on, y'all? This is the One Nation Podcast, 864. Y'all in the building with your boy Rook tonight, man. And I want to talk to y'all about a few things that's going on, you know, but I just wanted to vibe with y'all tonight, you know, get that one-on-one. We're going to sit back. We're going to sip a little Crown, and I'm going to talk to y'all. We're going to talk about some real stuff, man, that's going on in the world. And I want y'all attention to what's really going on. And the power of social media right now, it's really crazy, man. It's getting to the point now where you can do anything from the fingertips of your hand. You know, as long as you got this device in your hand, you can do whatever, man. But, yeah, the night, man, we're just going to chop it up a little bit, and we're going to dive right into this, man. So I'm going to go ahead, pull me up a little something, you know, and we're going to talk. You know, now let's talk about the old school days versus the new school days. So we're going to get into old school parenting, new school parenting, basically anything that has to do with the old school. Okay, make sure my mic on. But I was born in 86, okay, 36 years old. The era of the 80s, baby. We still rep it better than anybody. I don't care what y'all say. But, you know, each his own. But I come from an era, you know, where, you know, when your parents told you to do something, you do it. If you don't, you ain't got no other choice but get the hell knocked out of you. You know what I mean? And that's just how that was, man. And I feel like back then, and I'm not knocking the kids today because I'm doing this for a reason because I have three kids of my own. But I know back then, you know, when I came up, I had more than one mother around me, put it like that. You know, my homeboy's mother was my mother, vice versa with them. My other homeboy's mother was my mother, vice versa with them. And the mothers and the fathers, man, they really brought us up, you know, to respect, you know, all our peers. You know what I mean? And trust me, if my mother didn't get me and I was with this homeboy, that mother got me. Or if I was with that homeboy, that mother got me. Or vice versa with the fathers. That's just how it was. And it wasn't no bad blood against them because 9 times out of 10, you know when you're doing wrong and you for some reason you get that little itch, you still want to do it. And you know the consequences that's going to come from behind this. You know this. You know you're going to end up getting your butt tore up. Somebody going to end up hurt. It's going to be some crying going on. But at the end of the day, everything going to be all good. And tomorrow starts a new day, and it's like nothing ever happened. You know what I'm saying? And you could joke with your friends and stuff like that, man. And now, you know, fast forward to the new school today, I got 3 kids, you know, and trust me, I'm going to be the first to say this. My kids get out of line, I get out of line, if you know what I mean. You know what I'm saying? Because it's the way I was brought up. But at the same time, man, when you look at the way we was brought up, to nowadays, the way the kids are brought up, it's not the same. You know what I mean? Like, I know for a fact, you know, when I was brought up or back in the day when I wanted to do something, I would go ask my mother, right? And then let's just say I wanted to do something and she'd say, well, who's going with you? And I would say, such and such going with me. The new school today would just be like, okay, that's fine. The old school would be like, okay, well, I need to get in touch with such and such mother so I can make sure that this is right. You know what I mean? Kind of, they kind of checking up on you a lot more than what they do now. And I can remember times, man, to where I would actually do something I know was wrong. Know I'm going to get a whooping for it. I would take that L, take that whooping in silence or in public. Because back then, they didn't mind busting your butt in public either. You know what I'm saying? You get your ass tore up in public too. But I would take that. And then the next day, everything's cool, everything's fine. Because I still got love in my heart for my mother and whoever whooped me. That's just how it is. But when you play with today's age, man, you see a lot of violence going on, you know, behind that. Like, what I didn't know, I looked at something online the other day, and a lot of homicides, you know, they've been talking about. I didn't know it was a lot of kids that actually do bodily harm to their parents in the world. And then when you look at it, you try to figure out, you know, well, number one, it shouldn't be no reason you do any bodily harm to your parent. But then when you look at it and you read up on the article, it'd be something crazy. It'd be something like, yeah, because his mother told him no, he couldn't use the car. Or his mother told him no, he couldn't go out at this time. Like, really? What comes in your head to where you want to do bodily harm to your parents and go a step further, maybe even murder them? I don't understand that. I didn't hear about that like back in my day. Now, maybe it went on, but my circle, my era here in Spartanburg, South Carolina, you know, the crew I ran with, if you got your butt busted by your mom or your father, you got your butt busted by your mom and your father. At the end of the day, you still love them. We didn't think like that, and you shouldn't. These are the people that brought you into the world. Now, if you get out of line, they got the right to touch that behind. True that. But at the same time, you don't sit up there and you be plotting on how you going to get back your mother. That shows you really ain't got no feelings or no heart, man. I don't have my mother here with me, but it's not a time in my life where I can even thought about wanting to do something to my mother or my father. You know what I'm saying? That's just how it goes. But see, with the old school, we was raised off principles. Nowadays, it's like these kids just don't care. Because I be in the store sometimes. I gotta have to sip to this one. Now, check this out. I be in the store sometime, right? And it trips me out to where a child throws a tantrum. And when the child throws the tantrum, you know, I hear the mother say, stop that, or such and such. And the kid be wilding out. I mean, be throwing stuff in the stove, hitting the mom, hitting on the father, and they just trying to downplay it. No. Bust little Tim is ASS, if you know what I mean. Look here, man. You got to do what you got to do. And it got it to the point these days where, well, they'll call social service on you. Well, hell, somebody call social service on little Timmy because little Timmy out here beating the hell out of mom and dad. You can't do that, man. Back in the day, that wasn't how it was. You know what I'm saying? Back in the day, you get your butt whooped, ball game, that's it. It's nothing else to talk about. Boy, you going upstairs. Girl, you going upstairs. You go ahead and do what you got to do. Next day, you come down. Hey, you hungry? I'm going to go get you something to eat. Like nothing happened. But these days, like the kids have a revenge factor with them. I don't understand that, man. But that old school and that new school has definitely changed. Even the music and, you know, just the principles we raised up off of, man. And I don't know how a lot of y'all feel about it, but I feel like I still try to raise my kids off the principles I was taught when I was coming up. Yeah, I know it's a new day and age and things change, but I'm not changing the way I raised my child. Because the way my parents brought me up, I can honestly say, and, you know, all my friends, the way their parents brought them up, they did a darn good job. Now, at the end of the day, and I've been preaching this for a long, long time, I tell my kids this, you have to face yourself in the mirror. It's like temptation and the devil working at you. If you know something is wrong and you know the consequences from it, why do it? Why sit up there and like, you know what? Hell, I know this is the right way to do it. I'm going to go do it this way. At the end of the day, it's still going to be consequences. You know, and as you get older, the consequences get a little bit more rougher than just your parents laying their hands on you. Facing all kind of jail time, people want to do stuff to you. You know, you got to leave that alone, man. But that new school and the old school is definitely different. I thank God that I came up in the era that I came in because we really stand on principles. Not knocking nothing from the new era, but it was just a different time. You know, back then, man, we was locked in with everything. And now, with a new era, the new kids coming up, some of their parents, you know, They raised them off the same principles, you know, that we came up with, too. But you got a lot of them out here now, man, like a lot of the the parents want to be like the best friend to the kid. No, you got to be that child's parent. Now, at the end of the day, you know, I don't, me personally, I know we're still here. We're talking about being best friends with your kid. I don't want to be best friends with my kid. I want to be what I am to my kid, and that is my parent, a parent. I want to be a father to my children. Your best friend could be Justin or Monica. That's your best friend. But right here in this household, I'm your parent, and it's rules that we go by. And that's all I'm saying, man. But I do want to give a big shout out, you know what I'm saying, to all the parents around the world that's trying their best. You know, I salute you, and we're going to keep going. We're going to keep pushing, man, because it's really I hear a lot of people say it's pick your battles. I don't pick mine with my kids. You're either gonna do it or you're gonna be consequences. You know what I mean? That's just how that go, man. But it's a difference. It's definitely different between the old school and the new school. And we're gonna do a podcast on that later on into the year. You wanna come back, spin the block, we're gonna talk about that, get more deep into it. But I just wanted to touch on it tonight, just about some of the principles that we was raised off of and how some of the principles have gone away from the new school today. But another topic, man, we was talking about social media. Now, everybody has social media. Like I just said, it's in the palm of your hand. You got, and help me if I'm missing, you got Facebook, you got Snapchat, you got Instagram, you got TikTok, and it's a couple more out there too that I didn't even know about. People put me on today, but it's a lot of things going on in social media, and I can honestly say, man, that when I jumped on social media, not to tell my age or nothing, but when I jumped on social media, Facebook was for college kids, a way to keep in contact with each other, you know, and then quickly it became a big platform. It became a way that you can get on Facebook and, you know, and Facebook has a lot of advantages to it. You know, for me, I definitely use it for my platform, you know, definitely advertisements, definitely getting my word out there, promoting my brand and so on with everybody else's brand, you know, just getting different good feedback and stuff back from the business page. You can do a lot of things with, you know, that Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and the lot. It's a great, great platform, I think, for that now and these days. When I got on it, I remember when I jumped on Facebook first time, the only thing I was doing was sharing pictures, liking a whole bunch of other people's pictures, just adding friends, and just cutting up, you know, because I got some wild pictures I took on Facebook back in the day, man. It was just one of those things. We didn't have nothing else to do. You go out party, you know, take a picture of yourself, you and your partner, turning up, having a good time. That's what it's about. But just like we're evolving as people, you know, the platform for social media has definitely evolved. Like you can do anything on Facebook. But the thing I want to get at is also the power that social media has over some of us. Okay, because what really tripped me out, I sit back sometimes, I'm like, okay, you know, I look at certain things on Facebook, you know, we laugh, we cut up, we have a good time on Instagram, TikTok is crazy, they have some crazy stuff on there, Snapchat, but also, do we want our children looking at these same things? You know, because there's a lot of content out there these days. Everybody in the world has a Facebook page or social media. And, you know, they're putting out different content, different things here and there, whether they're right or wrong, they're still going to do it. I mean, it's their page. You can't tell them what to do with. But let me just paint this picture for you. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm going to use my daughter for example. And today's age, like we're just talking about old school, new school. I got a 6-year-old and a 4-year-old daughter, right? My 4-year-old picks up on a lot of things real quick. And I'm not going to name what video she's seen or what artist it was, but I'm scrolling through and I think I left my phone for something. So I had to go get my, I had, no, I know what I did. I was cooking a pizza. So I had to go get the pizza out of the oven. But you know, when you have a real loaf, it still plays. So my daughter's sitting there. And next thing I know, this child turned around and said, "Daddy, look." I look. She's doing this twerking motion. Oh, where you get that from? You twerking? What the? I looked, I seen who it was. I said, "Oh, okay." Plus, she had heard the song a couple times on the radio too. Now, fellas, women I'm talking to y'all too, but fellas, what would you do if you sitting there and your four-year-old daughter start twerking? I just want to know, what would you do? Crickets. Quiet, ain't it? Y'all don't want to talk about that, do you? Tell you what I did. Took the phone, closed it, went and got that pizza back out of the oven, and I gave her what we call the Rookert lecture. The Rookert lecture lets you know why you shouldn't do it, what's going to happen if you do it again, and you better not do it. And at the end of the Rookert lecture, you got two options. If you do it again, you're going to get messed up. And if I catch you doing it again, you're going to mess up. So either way it go, you're going to get your ass whooped. You know what I'm saying? But that's what social media has on a lot of our kids today. They see, they're visual. So they see things and they go out and do it. I wish it was a way we can like kind of like tone it down, because the kids are seeing a lot of things we're doing today. And when kids see something, if you don't check them or put them in the right place, then guess what? A kid's going to automatically do it. That's just how kids are. And we're in a place today where everybody goes off visual. You know, they see something, they do it. And, you know, it's not their fault, because we are the ones with the content up. We the ones letting them hear this. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, at the end of the day, social media has its advantages and its disadvantages. You know what I'm saying? It has the goods and its bad. But me, myself, I use it as a great marketing platform. I keep in contact with a lot of my friends. And I want to let y'all know, I seen something, Young Dolph. Rest in peace, Dolph. Long live Dolph. Preach. Y'all know that was my song. But anyway, I seen something Dolph said. Well, I heard something Dolph said on the interview. Dolph said, as long as you're holding this thing right here, and he had a phone in his hand, he said, you can become a millionaire. A millionaire. And when I sat back and looked at that, what Young Dolph talking about? I said, you're right, because you can do everything from your phone now. Everything. You can do any kind of, I see a lot of comedy skits that's coming out. And I want to shout out these guys that I have watched from the beginning on Facebook make it. Number one, Country Wayne. Salute to you, my guy. My guy, Desi Banks. Salute to you, my guy. My boy Bone, Skin Bone, I've been watching him out of Chicago. Salute to you, my guy. And I can't forget about my guy, E-Real. E-Real is the comedian. Salute to you, my guy. Them guys took their phone, something that they have on a daily basis, started shooting content, posting it to Facebook, and look what happened. They got their word out there. They got their brand out there. And I'm just trying to let y'all know that as long as you got that thing in your hand, you're really walking around and you don't know what you have. You can be a millionaire. You can go ahead and do what you got to do. Promote your brand. You can go out there and promote another person's brand. It's all within a click of a button in your fingertips. You just got to know what to do with it. You got to know how to market it. Strategize. Do what you got to do. And there's a lot of ways to do that, man. And that's like the phone, social media, it's a big thing today. You know, I don't go nowhere without my phone. But then you have people that use their phone for the wrong reasons. We understand that. But I'm talking about the positive part of it, not the negative. So just remember that. As long as you got that phone, you can do whatever you want to do. You go ahead, start getting your plan together, start scripting, you know, promoting, putting your content out, and you can go from there. And like I say, you don't just have Facebook. You got Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat. TikTok is major. Y'all definitely need to check that out, especially business TikTok. It's doing big things. But another thing for your friends out there, and you don't understand how serious it is. Like, if your friend is starting something, all you got to do is click a share and it can go anywhere. That's supporting. I think people got supporting mixed up in a lot of different ways. This is what I call support. I may have a friend that haven't bought not one thing from me, but have sat there and liked, shared, or even just barbershop talked about my page or my business. That's support. You know, a friend don't necessarily got to go out and buy your product. Because your friend is your friend. They may not even like the product, but at the same time, they rock with you. I'm going to help my guy or my girl get this out here. I'm going to share. I'm going to support. I'm going to subscribe. Stuff like that. So I don't like it when people say, my friend has to support me. And I'll be like, well, your friend support you at all? No, they ain't bought none of my stuff. Well, your friend was the one that shared your post. Your friend was the one that spoke about your brand to this person. Your friend was the one that helped you hold a camera this way. Your friend was the one that did a video shoot or a photo shoot for you for nothing. And then that goes a long way, because once they share, somebody else sees it. You and your friends don't always have the same friends. So when they share it out, get the one of their friends, they share it out. Your stuff is going everywhere on social media. It's going everywhere through the world. That's the biggest support system you can have. Not just necessarily a friend going out, buying your t-shirt or buying your product and boom, that's it. No, when they share your stuff, that's kind of like going long ways. You know what I mean? So understand that too, man. When it comes to support, that's what friends do. And I got people that I'm not even close with that share my stuff. And I really thank y'all on the daily, man, because I want to say this has been one of the best things that I'm doing and I'm proud of. I love the podcast scene. I love everything, man. And I just want to say, hey, thanks for the support. We appreciate it. But on to the next topic and the last topic, man. I want to know exactly how do y'all... Let me see. A friend of mine was talking about this the other day. Now, there's a lot of things going on in the world. You know, I mean, you got things that's going on with kids in school, politics. I'm not ready to even dive into none of that yet. Sports world and everything, man. But I think we need to give credit where credit is due. And I don't think the teachers of the world get enough credit. What I mean by that, every morning we get up and we put trust in a set of people with our kids. We drop our kids off, or a school bus or however it does, drops our kids off at a place 5 days out of the week, right? Each one of our kids go to a certain classroom where it's ran by a certain adult, which we call their teacher or professor. And they deal with our kids on a different level than we do. Academics. And we sit back sometimes and we be like, oh, my son got A's or my daughter got A's and B's. We know where they get that from. We know. Let's take a pause right quick. We may have been smart coming through school. A lot of us may have made A's and B's or whatever. And yes, our kids do have our genetics in them. But we are not the ones teaching our kids the academics. You know how many times my son come home to me and he tell me something about an animal, or he tell me something about history that I don't even know. I didn't learn him that. I didn't teach him that. I owe that to that teacher at that school. Yes, they have our genetics in them. But at the same time, we're not the ones teaching them. We don't give them enough credit. You got to think about it. A teacher's in a classroom filled with students, right? I don't know how many kids you all have, but I got three. So I take me for example. I deal with three different attitudes, three different emotions, and three different ways of seeing life every day. This teacher has to deal with up to maybe 18 different emotions, 18 different attitudes, 18 different kids are seeing life in a different way. That is hard to do. And keep them on the right track at the same time. That's tough. Oh, we could say, yeah, they bring home A's, B's. We was like that coming through school, but somebody taught us too. Like a lot of these things that you learn, actually, the history parts, the math, the all the academic credentials, all that. Somebody taught us that. 9 times out of 10, it wasn't our parents. Yeah, when we come to math, counting 1 to 10, but when it gets on up into geometry, trigonometry, whatever you took, world history, science, you know, different things like that. Somebody had to teach us that. And just like these teachers don't get enough credit. They are the ones teaching our kids. They are the ones teaching the kids everything they need to know. They're teaching our future. We need to give them more props. We need to give them more credit. And I just want to say, I salute to all the teachers and the professors out there around the world, because, and this is another one, especially if they got to deal with 18 different attitudes, then come home and they got kids of their own and deal with 1 to 5 different attitudes, I salute you. I give you all the credit in the world. And we trust you all with our children to keep them safe, keep them out of harm's way, and to give them the knowledge they need. You know, I'm going to give a shout out to my first grade teacher I still remember, named Miss Rita. Miss Rita, Jesse Bobo. Miss Rita, my mom is not here no more with us. But my mom shouted you out every day that she could, especially when it came to any academics. Because you instilled something in me that stuck with me all the way up through elementary, middle, high, and the little year and a half I did at college. And it was simply the words you taught me. Thomas, if you open your mind up, you can do anything and be anything you want to be. I took that seriously. This is my first grade teacher, y'all. And I salute her. I love her. Somebody tagged Miss Rita in this video. And I want her to see this. But we salute y'all. And that's just one thing we do here on the One Nation Podcast 864. We give you your flowers. We give you your credit where it's due. And like I say, we always talk about this and about that going on in the world. We always keep it real. But at the end of the podcast and throughout the podcast, we're going to keep the positivity going. And it's always a positive message behind everything. That's what we got to see. But that's about my time with y'all tonight, man. I love y'all, but remember these things. You can be a millionaire as long as you got a phone in your hand. The power within these fingertips, the social media, can get you going. Remember the principles we stood on from the old school. Go back to that. If you're in a new school, go back to that. Go back to what your mother and father taught you back then. Let's raise these kids up right. And last but not least, we salute the teachers and the professors all around the world. That's just how that go. But this is your boy Rook. I'm going to sip one more time. And we're going to end this. And this is the One Nation Podcast 864. This is your boy Rook, and I'm signing out. Peace.